Hello everyone, a happy International Yoga to you all. So on this occasion I would like to share my knowledge regarding yoga. So there are many people who are following my channel, maybe yoga teachers are also there, but my knowledge I am sharing with you. Many people are having an understanding yoga means only the thing is that only asanas. Yoga is not just asanas, it's a part of asanas. And what is this yoga? Yoga means joining or binding the mind and body. Mind and body together, no madam, how we have to join, it's already joined, you may have a doubt. Let me have you clear idea, let me give you. The main thing is that when you are in front of me, when you are in class, when you are in office, when you are doing something, but your mind will be somewhere. Though your body is present, mind may goes to New York, New Jersey, New Delhi, somewhere. In a fraction of seconds, it goes very fastly. So to control that mind, to bind together that body and mind together, yoga is the best way. Yoga is the cheapest and also less time. Time also very less time it will take. Less expensive and easy to follow. So this is the benefit of yoga. And yoga is the fitness mantra of body and mind together. So related to this, I'm going to share with you few more topics like what is yoga. Yoga is related to three things. One is asanas, another one is pranayamam and meditation. These three things together we can say it as yoga. And the people who are following this yoga, who are doing yoga, who are seriously working out for this yoga, so they have to remember one thing along with yoga. Yoga means pranayama, meditation, asanas. Along with this yoga, you need to be very careful about your food habits also. Balanced diet you have to take and sound sleep. Sound sleep is possible when you don't have tensions. When you are happy, when you don't have any flashbacks, when you take everything light. So when you balance your mind, then only you'll have the sound sleep. So related to this sound sleep, I have prepared one video, that is Yoga Nidra. So that link is given in the downside of the description box, you can just follow it. Food habits and sound sleep. These two are very important when you are doing yoga. So and general queries I want to discuss with you. Most of the people are having this doubt. So let me discuss some questions. The first question is that when to start yoga? Anytime you can start yoga. There is no age difference. There is no barrier of age. Anytime, irrespective of age, gender, caste, religion, anything, you can start yoga. So I would suggest at childhood, school life only, if you start, better it is. But anyway, anytime you can start this yoga. And this is about the age, whatever may be the age. If you start early, your body will be more flexible and your mind is also tuned up according to that. If you want to have concentration, if you want to reach your ambitions, right age is early age. But any time you can start yoga. And you know that many people are having a idea about like when health is down, let's go for yoga. Back pain I'm having and I'm having some spondylosis, this and that, diabetes, thyroid, then I'll go for yoga. No, it is not like this. Patanjali Maharshi has invented this yoga. He has given a very good instructions. He has written this yoga. He introduced this yoga thousands of years back. Not for these diseases. For fitness of body, for fitness of mind. A fit, well-fit body, a well-fit mind can practice this. So if you start right from the beginning without any diseases, that would be much better. You can prevent these diseases. So anytime you can start this yoga. And second question is how long to do this yoga? You can do as long as possible. I would say in fact frankly, as long as you are alive, please do yoga. Or in other words, as long as you take food, do yoga. It doesn't matter, it doesn't take much time, no problem at all, no pain at all. In fact, you'll have a lot of advantages like balancing your body, mind and all these things, it is possible. So that is why as long as you are, you can do this yoga. And some people ask, can I do for 1 month or 1 week or 6 months, 1 year, is it okay? No, please continue as long as possible. You feel very fresh, light body, light mind. Once if you find the advantages, you will not leave. And next question is how long to do? or how to do this yoga. How to do this yoga means you can start yoga with the initial exercises. So initial exercises are fundamental exercises, fundamental asanas. Please consult any nearby yoga guru and take their suggestions and start yoga, small exercises. Then in future you can go for advanced yoga also. And while doing yoga, please remember your mind should be under control. You think about only about the present, and please concentrate, focus on breathing and counting. For every asana will count 10 times or otherwise half minute, 1 minute, 2 minutes. So half minute means 30 you have to count. Like, you please concentrate on only on counting and breathing, how you are taking breathing, on that only. So this is very important thing while doing yoga. And next question is that, can we stop yoga? Please don't stop. And some people are having doubt, if I stop yoga, can I have am I going to get any side effects? No side effects, but please continue this yoga forever. And this is about asanas. Now coming to the meditation, what is this meditation? Meditation means nothing but doing nothing. Doing nothing is meditation, just focusing on your breathing, it's called as meditation. A simple example I'll give you. Suppose you were walking in rain half an hour, 30 minutes. After that you wanted to enter inside of your house. What do you do? First you'll clean your body, first feet, and then you'll take bath, you'll clean your body, then you'll go to your room. So in the same way, meditation is also. Every day you have to clean your mind with meditation. As you clean your foot, as you clean your body, in the same way, you have to clean your mind with meditation. So regarding this meditation, I have already prepared a video, special video. So that link I am sharing in the downside. It's in English version and also in Telugu version. Please watch it. This is about meditation. And next one is that pranayama. Pranayama means nothing but to control the breathing. If we control the breathing, we'll have a long life, healthy life. So breathing should take less times. In a minute, if you see, generally we take 15 times. So this breathing, you have to control it. We can come down to 15 to 10, 10 to 5 in a minute breathing, with breathing exercises. Pranayama, this we call. So if you see a small example like a rabbit takes many times the breathing. In 1 minute, if you count the breaths, it takes many times. Its life is very short. Whereas if you take tortoise takes very less breathing, very less. But its life is very long. There are some tortoise who are living since or more than 200 years. So like, to control the breathing, breathing is the main problem of our body. If we can control our breathing, your life will be very long. So for that, pranayama, breathing exercises. Through breathing exercise also, we can control a lot of diseases. This is about breathing. And 10 times in the beginning stage you'll have. Then after that, you can come down to 10 and 10 to 5. Like, through breathing exercise, you can decrease your breathing. Now I'll share with you few asanas which are useful for a particular reason or particular thing we can use it. The first thing is that concentration. If you want to enhance your concentration, memory power, please do some kind of asanas like Vrikshasana, very important one, Vajrasana, Padmasana and Vakrasana. These four asanas are very good for concentration. And next thing is that diabetes. Diabetes nowadays is quite common. So to control the diabetes, you can follow Siddhasana, Shirshasana, Chakrasana, Halasana, Matsasana and Mayurasana. These 5-6 are good for diabetes. The next one is that if you are having high blood pressure, high BP, then you can follow some asanas like Vajrasana, Padmasana, Siddhasana, Matsasana and Shavasana. So these are good for high BP. And also for bad cholesterol. Bad cholesterol, I would suggest Kapalbhati is very good to control the bad cholesterol. Daily please do Kapalbhati 5 minutes. Every day increase it 1 minute like this. Today I have done 5 minutes. Tomorrow 6 minutes, 7 minutes, like 30 minutes it has to be. High cholesterol, it will come down easily. And another thing is that very common problem is weight reduction. to decrease the weight, Surya Namaskara is the best way, and also Uttana Padasana, you can do Makarasana, and grinding exercises are going to be very helpful. Stretching your legs and doing this. Grinding reverse and clockwise, anti-clockwise, you can do this. So this is very good one, and Kapalbhati is also good. Viloma Anuloma Pranayama you can do, and automatically your weight will decrease. And please remember, controlling food habits are very important, especially night time. Take very less food, avoid ice creams, junk food and sweets, all these things. And you know that once if you start doing this yoga, you will not have much hunger also. So you don't feel hungry. Please do remember this point, food habits and exercises, as I told you. And another one is thyroid, also one of the biggest problem nowadays. To control that thyroid, you can go for Matsasana, Ushnasana, Bhujangasana, Kapalbhati. And Viloma Anuloma Pranayama is also going to be very helpful for thyroid. And all these pranayams, if you do it according asanas or pranayam, it will be much helpful for you. You know that foreigners are learning yoga and they are becoming trainers, yoga trainers. It's our culture. Yoga is our culture, and people are learning, people are spreading, they are loving it, they are knowing the results and all those things. So they are becoming one of the best followers for this yoga. Why can't we? So don't say that I don't have time. Everyone will have time. PM Modi is having time to do yoga, but we don't have. So please remember, 5 minutes in a day, take out. Do this yoga for 5 minutes for 1 week. Next week you feel like increasing that time automatically. You'll take out some time. So that's the power of yoga. It's our culture. Please enhance and spread the yoga and do yoga and get the advantages of body and mind fitness mantra yoga. So thank you very much for all your affection. The same talk is available in my Telugu channel, Devika Bhatnagar's Telugu channel, in Telugu Talk. So please stay connected with me for more talks. Happy Yoga Day once again to all of you. So take care, keep smiling, keep shining. Good luck.